Someday in the late fall, if you're going through the woods of South Jersey, listen carefully as the wind comes off the ocean through the pines. It almost seems like the wind is trying to tell us something, possibly someone's name. Old Mother Leeds. Old Mother Leeds. It seems that Jane Leeds and her husband Daniel lived at the edge of a great swamp along the Mullica River. Now, folks in those parts said that it was a strange family, an unusual family. Some even said that Jane Leeds was a witch. Well, we know it was an unusual family in the sense that they had so many children. Jane Leeds had so many children. She had 12 children. And she was exhausted from the picking things up, putting things away, the cleaning, the cooking, the chopping the wood. She was really at her wit's end. Now, her husband, Daniel, he was a good provider in the sense that he was a good fisherman, he was a good hunter, he was a good gardener. There was always food on the table. That wasn't the problem. The problem was that he took very little interest in the children. So what happened, Jane Leeds, when she learned that she was pregnant with her 13th child, in a moment of perhaps understandable weakness, when she said, "Lord, let this one not be a child, let this one be a devil." Well, we now know that that was a mistake, because on that terrible February night of 1735, when Mother Leeds' 13th child was born, it started out as a perfectly normal, healthy little baby boy with blue eyes and blonde hair. Everything seemed fine, but in the space of less than 20 minutes, the baby grew to a creature the size of two full-grown men. And in place of the little baby face, there was a horrible head of a horse. The creature had the head of a horse, the torso of a man, the feet of a goat, leathery bat-like wings, and a long serpentine tail. Had a powerful torso and massive biceps, long arms, and all covered with fur. And at the end of each furry arm was a furry paw. At the end of each paw were long, bony fingernails with razor-sharp fingernails. And then, unpredictably, with one swipe of his right arm, the creature slit the throat of the midwife, who collapsed in a pool of blood. The creature gave out a blood-curdling scream and escaped out the chimney, where he's terrified the people of South Jersey for the last 250 years. Now, folks in these parts say that something at night startles the cattle, and the next day the milk turns sour. Tool buildings and sheds are turned over in the middle of the night. Strange tracks are found round about. Places in the forest are scorched. Well, have you seen Mother Leeds' 13th child? The next time you go in the woods at night, take care. And when you hear the sudden crack of a twig behind you, beware. Beware of the Jersey Devil.